Losing streaks in Tarkov can feel like one of the most frustrating things ever. It starts with a single loss, and then back-to-back losses. And next thing you know, you haven't survived a single raid for the day. And these bad days of Tarkov can eventually lead you into a full burnout from the video game. This is one of the most punishing video games out there that can bring you to a full tilt where it starts to affect your in-game performance for the worse. So today we are going to be talking about ways I personally get through these bad stretches of Tarkov and sometimes even turn it around into a good day. The first thing that helps me with getting through a bad day of Tarkov or a bad stretch of Tarkov, and is probably one of the more obvious answers as well, is taking a break from the video game. The length of the break is all subjective and up to you, but it could be a quick 15-minute break, 30-minute break, or it could be a day, a few days, even a week. But it's what we do during that break is what I feel is important to me. When you do take that step away from Tarkov, there are many things you can do depending on how long that break is. If it's a quick one, then a quick walk around or getting some sun might help just to reset the mind. For longer ones that are either a few hours or a few days, maybe play a totally different video game for a while. But what personally helps me a lot are two things. First, I enjoy watching other Tarkov streamers or content creators, and I take inspiration from their playstyle and add my own twist to it to create a new unique playstyle that fits me. And second, one of my favorite things to do in my off time or when I'm taking a step back from Tarkov is taking inspiration from movies or TV shows. A perfect example of this is the John Wick franchise. I can watch John Wick 1, 2, and 3 over and over again and never get sick of it and get completely inspired by the action scenes that I hope to transfer into Tarkov. Just a week ago, I rewatched the third John Wick that just recently came out on Netflix, and there was a scene where John Wick was using a loud MPX, and I got so inspired by that action sequence that on my next stream, I ended up using a loud MPX and just took it around and I just enjoyed myself. So the bottom line of what I'm trying to say is take inspiration from streamers, content creators, fellow Tarkov players, TV shows, movies, and get inspiration for a change of pace that you can apply in your next session of Tarkov. And when you do come back to Tarkov after taking a little break from it and things are still not going well, the next thing I encourage you to do is to change things up. There are multiple ways to change things up. Are you always solo? Play with a squad. Do you keep playing customs? Play interchange. Are you always using automatic rifles? Try semi-autos or DMRs. Are you a hyper-aggressive player? Try to change it up. Maybe play a little slower next time. The idea behind this is to figure out if maybe there's something that's just not working for you right now. And maybe when you change things up, you realize you're actually a better player when you're using DMRs or shotguns, or you're a better player when you're in interchange. Also, in my opinion, switching it up keeps the game fresh and avoids burnout. In the last couple of patches, I have been maining bolt-action sniper rifles because it came to a point where I started getting burned out of the usual automatic rifle or SMG metas. And this burnout naturally led to just bad stretches of Tarkov. And it came to a point where I needed a change of pace because I realized I no longer enjoyed that type of loadout. And when I switched to bolt-action rifles, it changed everything for me. It changed my playstyle from aggressive to slow, and it changed the maps I enjoyed running because I needed maps that supported that slow sniper rifle gameplay. And my love for sniping continues to evolve. In the recent days, to change things up, I started using a Mosin with the PU scope. The idea behind maining the Mosin with a PU scope was I wanted to get better at fixed scopes. Because usually when I'm sniping, I'm using the Voodoo, the TAC-30, or the Valde, any variable scope, and I felt like using a fixed scope would just change the whole sniping experience. And it really did. And this constant change of loadouts and playstyles has honestly not only kept Tarkov fresh for me, but has improved my performance as a Tarkov player. It allowed me to get to know myself more as a Tarkov player. I started to figure things out that I'm really good at and things that I'm really bad at as well. I also feel like a more well-rounded player than I used to be. A bad stretch of Tarkov can usually be defined by having more losses than we'd like. And with these multiple losses, we tend to see that death screen over and over and over again. What may help with this is taking little wins. Little wins can be as simple as going in a map, killing 2 to 3 scavs, filling up half your bag, and seeing that survive screen. Doing scav runs, looting up, and surviving also counts as little wins. In a stretch where I'm just getting demolished and dying all day, seeing those little survive screens over and over again can help with my confidence and my mental state. Another tip that can help, and something I can't help but reiterate and keep talking about, is learning from your losses. I always encourage people to record their raids if their computer is capable of doing that, because you learn a lot from your wins and especially your losses. Reviewing footage and seeing what you could have done better is probably one of the best ways to drastically become a better player. There are a ton of moments you might miss or not realize in the heat of the moment that you may see when you're reviewing footage. There's a lot of value and small details you can get from reviewing video clips. You'll be able to look back and think, should I have peeked that corner? Should I have stayed in this area a little longer? Maybe you didn't check your corner. In my experience, most of my losses is usually me lacking the attention to detail when I'm in raid. Tarkov is like a chess match. One wrong move and you're gone. Learning from your losses was also something I discussed in another YouTube video I made called How to Deal with Solo Anxiety and Escape from Tarkov. Look at the top right of your screen. You should see an info card that leads to that video if you want to check it out. The last but definitely not the least tip I can offer when dealing with bad stretches of Tarkov is knowing that losing will happen a lot in Escape from Tarkov. When on a losing streak, realizing that losing a lot is a normal thing in this game, and that's what also makes winning a lot sweeter. The one thing I always tell friends about this game, or even new players, is that the appeal of Tarkov is like losing 10 games in a row, and then your 11th raid, you come out with just like 70, 80 kilos worth of meta gear, where you drop 2 or 3 level 40, level 50 guys, and you're just chugging home with about a million worth of rubles in your bag. And these wins usually come after streaks and streaks of losses. My point is, losing is a part of Tarkov, and also, honestly, a part of life. As the saying goes, you win some, you lose some. But when you take those big L's, that's what makes winning a lot sweeter. I know the feeling though, after a long day at work or school, you come home to play some Tarkov, and sometimes it can make you feel like it's making your day worse. When it does come to that, I hope this video helps in the smallest of ways. If you guys made it to this point of the video, thanks for listening, and do leave in the comments, how do you deal with your bad days? I hope you guys got some value out of this video, and don't forget to hit the like button if you guys enjoyed the video. It does help the channel a lot with the algorithm, and for more Tarkov content, do subscribe if you haven't. If you guys want to catch the live streams, I do stream Monday to Friday, twitch.tv/ramenstyle. Hope to see you guys there, and I will see you guys on the next video.